about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way.
Hey, I'm going on live now. I just accidentally called you.
Robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way.
Hello?
Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray.
This is Stonewall's Way here, and I was sorry about the moment interruption of that call. Got a call right when the stream was starting. Anyways, we're going to start a new game with Crusader Kings 3, and this game's pretty strategic and very interesting. It's just really cool how you get to play this game. So we're going to start a new game, and we're going to start in, I think it's the Great Adventures, here we are, we're going to play as Alfred the Great. He's a very smart character, very intelligent, very hard hitting, and we're going to see how far we go in this sandbox and see how it goes. We're gonna go in Iron Man mode. I don't know if I want to do. Oh yeah, we're gonna do normal so we get the achievements. And let's see. 1st of January, 867 AD. Wrath of the Northmen. 2 years ago, King Ella of Northumbria threw the great Viking hero Ragnar Lothbrok into a pit of snakes to die. Upon hearing the news, Ragnar's sons set sail for England to avenge their father. The brothers have since established a firm foothold in York and the Isles. The Anglo-Saxon kings have lost battle after battle. Their future looks bleak indeed, but all hope is not lost, and a great hero can still turn the tide of history. Will you lay all of England under Norse rule, or vanquish the great heathen army from Anglo-Saxon soil? Alright, our difficulty is hard, our faith is Catholicism, and our culture is Anglo-Saxon. As the Vikings push further south, Earl Alfred of Dorset is readying his troops. In the coming years, Alfred will fight numerous battles against the Norsemen and put an end to the invasion. When he inherits his brother's throne, he becomes one of the greatest English kings throughout history. Will you fulfill Alfred's great destiny or be crushed by the great heathen army? One last thing before we start this game. I'm going to go to the settings here. I'm going to turn down the audio, master audio, to about 80%. Music to at least 50%. And the sound effects will turn down to 70%. There we go. Because that was a little too loud. Let me look and see at the stream here if we got anyone watching. It says we have one viewer. I don't know who that is. Anyways, we'll go ahead and we'll start the game. Alfred the Great. Alright, you can already see I played this game before, and we're going to start with the save of Alfred Stream. Start Iron Man. You're going to see how cool this game is, because this is pretty interesting. Alright, Alfred the Great begins with the trait honest, just, gregarious, diligent, brilliant strategist, forest fighter, and intelligent. And his wife is compassionate, generous, diligent, and gray eminence. So she's good with diplomacy, which can come in very, very much in handy. All right, let's look at our kingdom. We are part of Wessex. And let's see here. We are, this is our realm, which is Dorset. We have East Anglia, Mercia, Gwynedd, Duthbar, oh man, this pronunciation, Gwent, Jorvik, Northumbria, Alba, otherwise known as Scotland, and then we have all the principalities of Ireland, which have not, Ireland has not become a nation yet. We are at war against Jarl Ivar. He has 6,900 troops against our 4,900. And what else are we at war with? The Sons of Lodbrok. They have 7,000 against our force of 4,600. So we got to think of what we're going to have to do here in a minute. But let's go ahead and look at this huge map. So if you are new to Crusader Kings 3, you can play as any one of these nations on this huge map. Way down here where Guana is, you can play in Africa. You can play in the Middle East. You can play over in India and the far reaches of China. Also, you can play as the Mongols over in the Far East. So, very interesting game. You can play as the Vikings too, but being a Christian gamer, I like to side with Alfred the Great, because I want to stop the Vikings from spreading their paganism throughout England. I want to drive them out of England, because even though they've come to farm the land and live in peace, I do not like paganism and their ways from infecting the minds and lives of my people. So, what are we going to do about it? What's the plan? Well, first off, I'm going to have to raise an army over here in Dorset. And we're going to have to try to defeat the smaller armies of the Vikings as soon as possible. Let's see, we have 830 men. Not quite a lot. Let's see here. I'm just looking at the mercenaries, how much they cost. I could go into debt and pay for some mercenary bowmen. But it's gonna, I don't know the long-term effects. Anyways, here's the realm page. This shows you your realm. We have an autonomous vessels under our current realm. Our military, our levies, these are our knights. Over here is the knights that are on our side. And we could recruit this guy to fight with us, but I don't know if I want to spend the money just yet. This is our men-at-arms. They're the ones that always stay at a good number of men, which this is 100 men and 100 huskarls. So that is that. I'm really thinking of getting this Gwendolyn archers. And by having these archers... we can't get it. Hire this mercenary company since it'll put you too much in debt. So our best option right now is to help our king to defeat the enemy army. However, let's see what we can do if we have any children. We have some siblings, but we don't have children. So, there, we can't arrange marriage because we're Christian. We can get a court physician, which will be handy. Null appoint my wife, I think. There's so much to think about in this game. I'm like indecisive right now. I just gotta think for a second. What do I want to do with the money that I have? Whether I'm going to save it or I'm going to spend it on something stupid like getting another medic. These are the decisions we can make with this quill and pen here. We can search for a physician, call, hunt, go on a pilgrimage, develop capital, and invite knights. I'm going to go for search for physician. And I'm going to go to lifestyle, marshal. We already got strategist. So, I think we want to go with, strategy focus, but we're going to get, knight effectiveness, 75, that'll be nice. That's what we'll get, go aim for. This is going to be hard in the beginning. I don't know how we're going to do it, how we're going to pull it off, but we just have to. Because this whole realm is at stake. Alright. That will begin. Alright, court physician. We have resentful gambler and dishonorable villain. Let's see what their stats are. He's more indulgent rastral. I thought they called him indulgent weasel. Indulgent weasel. he's stubborn, diligent. Doesn't look good. This person doesn't look good either. Let's see. I don't really care for any of them, so I'm just both failed to impress me. And I'm gonna go to my court physician. I'm gonna put my wife in there. All right. Neutral army. We gotta think of what we're going to do to defeat these villains. We'll just play for now, and we'll have an army there just in case. Unfortunately, we can't do anything other than follow these guys, because if we go too far without them, our 854 man army is not going to do nothing against 7,000 soldiers. We should take out this army over here with our inferior numbers. But they won't follow me. Let's see. Come on. Split off. There's a way that if you press this attach to army button, they can follow you. Oh no, I got sick. Yeah, that's right, go after them. We need to destroy them before they get their full amount of men. Come on, get them before they get away. Good job. 1,000. Now we're following the army, but our forces are retreating. They're retreating too, though. Come on, hurry up. My men are always behind. So we have 4,000 men. Empty council position. Ah, we need to fill that right now. Marshal. This guy seems to be the best. Let's go ahead and look to what we got in our courtiers. We have a guest, competent diplomat, your wife. It's too bad that we can't have Sigrid as our marshal. She's a brilliant strategist, reaver, calm, gregarious, and jest. She'd make a perfect, let's see if she's married. No, she's not married, so we're going to play matchmaker. And we're that way she will get someone that is, she'll get someone that has her traits, hopefully. Just forgiving, generous. This guy is 35. I'm gonna match them up with them. All right, let's go ahead. I wonder though, invite knights. Only cost crowns, good. We'll invite some knights to come. It's hard to follow these guys. So far, we're winning the war against the Sons of Lothbrok invasion of East Anglia, which is good for us. But they're gonna be coming, and when they do, we gotta be ready for them. Sister-in-law. Ah! Who is she married to? I think she was married... I think she was married to, the guy that just died. Yep. She was. Okay. So... Alright, Chaz. Anyone here? Oh, hi, Alan. I see ya. I haven't been paying attention to the chat. I'm so sorry. All right, Alan, you're going to name this little girl. I think it's a little girl, right? Yep, she should be blessed with a good name. So, Alan, what should we name the little girl? Alan, what do you suggest we name this little girl? Let's look at the Christian names. Patricia, Brigid, Joanne, Maria, Rachel, Constance, Brigid, Stephanie, Judith, Anna, Sophia, Stephanie, Judith, Constance, Anna, same stuff. Oh, he wants me to lower the quality just a bit. Let's see what I could do. Yeah, I can't lower the quality, Alan, but yeah, I'll name her Sophia. Sophia. There we go. Sophia is actually my sister's name. She lives in Reading. Alright, we had our first battle. So now we're going to combine merge armies, because you know what just happened? Hold on, we're going to pause. Let's see, what just happened? I just became king, basically. So, this whole kingdom of Wessex is now mine. So I gotta defend this whole kingdom against the great Viking horde that is attacking right now. This is my allied army. And we gotta figure out how to defeat the Vikings. Let's see. They have 2,900 plus another 2,000 plus another 2,000. So that's 6,900. I only got this 3,000 men. My allies are over here, so if I combine with them, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 500, that's still not going to be enough to defeat this enemy army. Also, they have these men here, so they're going to come after us after they're done with Northumbria. Not good. We're just going to have to patiently deal with them a little later. Alright, let's see who we got for our knights. Your guest, Copsidge. He is 14 military marshal. That means he'd make a good knight. It's 40 to recruit him. And let's see, let's go look at our court. Oh man, we need to put this on pause. So this is our court here. Let me explain how this all works. This is my wife. She can assist me with politics, chivalry, which is martial, domain, court intrigue, and patronage, which is learning. The bishop, he is the head of faith. He helps me fabricate claims and religious relations and convert faith in counties. So if any of these counties become pagan, I can send him over to convert them. My chancellor, I want to get someone. I have to look over here too. These people have a lower opinion of me because I haven't made them part of the council. So a lot of this is just politics and intrigue on what should happen. These are all the people that are in my realm right here, and they're all angry with me or somewhat okay with me, but I have to figure out what's best for my empire. So who do I choose as my chancellor? I think this guy with great eminence is going to be helpful. So I'm going to choose him. We could use him on domestic affairs or foreign affairs. We're going to use him on domestic affairs at first. Now we have to go for our steward, the guy that manages our money. We have to make sure he's trustworthy because he has all the money. Alright, let's see. This guy here is diligent, ambitious, and stubborn. He would make a good, because look at his stewardship right here. That means he's good at money. Let's see, who else is good at money here? I'm just going to assign him. Marshall. This guy is a brilliant strategist, and he's reckless, so he's in. Spymaster. Your knight. I'm thinking of who I want to have. I'm going to assign that guy so we can make him happy, since he's one of my earls. Alright, so what's our plan with these guys over here? What are we going to do about them? Because they're combined. See, what's going to happen is I'm going to march my army over here, and I'm going to just try to take out this army of 2,000 men. Now, as soon as I do that, the computer, they're going to all combine and take me out, like with about 7,000 or 8,000 men. So that's not going to work. So I could hire mercenaries, which is 180 for like 442 men or 700 men. That's not a whole lot of men. These guys could help me, but I think I'm just not going to worry about them for right now. And I'm going to come back here, and I'm going to command these guys to join forces with me. We're being raided by this guy here. We're above the domain limit. We'll solve that by putting her in managed domain, which solves it a little bit. We gotta look at our domain. Alright, so in medieval times, you had a domain limit of how much you could keep. And right now I have 9 castles that I have. I can't hold 9 castles, so I gotta do something about it. We're gonna give Kent away. I think Kent. Let's see. Yep, Kent. Alright. So now I gotta remember how we get to Kent. Great Kingdom of Kent. Alright, grant to. Who are we going to grant it to? Should we give it to a lowborn person? These are people that don't have any land at all, or they have just a simple little cottage somewhere. We could give it to them, and they'll be indebted to us for forever. Or we can give it to someone who already has land, like this guy here. Decisions, decisions. If we give the people that have land too much land, they'll possibly rise up against us in the future. So we gotta find somebody with good traits that we could trust. This guy is meet us touch, trusting, arbitrary, and honest. I like this guy. I think I'm gonna make him a vassal. And he's indebted to me. Alright, so now our domain limit is 6 to 8, so we are good. Victory, victory. What else we got here? Powerful vassals. We already dealt with that. You declare war and Count Olrif. Where is he at? Ah, he has Lyon. Lyon. Holy War Kingdom. 600. Okay, so these are the type of wars we can declare. We can go to a holy war. So since we're Catholic and they're pagan, we can declare a holy war. And for an amount of crosses, which is 80, which is our faith output right here, we can declare war. We can't do it with our armies raised, though, but when our armies are unraised, we can declare war and get at least one of the counties. And that's County of Lyon. So I think it's the whole county, actually. Interesting. Okay, let's go ahead and play, because this will get boring after a while. Alright, we attached that army to us, so hopefully they follow us. Oh, our queen's pregnant! Yes! Preggers! Okay, awesome. So we're gonna have a heir to the throne. Alright. Alright, what are these guys doing? We have 3,000 men, 1,800. I think we can do this. Let's see if we can defeat them. Hopefully we get there in time. I don't think we will. Yeah, they're going to get this fort besieged, and then they're going to be free to help. So we can't do that. Who joined? Alright, I'm sitting around the map table with Earl Edmund and Earl Uhtred discussing our strategy for the ongoing war. Edmund eagerly points out all the prime targets we should immediately send raiding parties to pillage, while Uhtred explains how we need to watch what our foes do and respond accordingly. It's my right to decide our ultimate course of action. You know what's interesting about this is that I have Netflix right now, and there's this TV show. I don't know if you heard of it. It's not called Vikings. It's called The Last Kingdom, and it's all wrapped around a Viking he's a Northumbrian who becomes a Viking, and then he fights for the Saxons, and his name is Uhtred. So it's kind of, it's based on a historic character, and I'm wondering if this guy right here, Earl Uhtred of Middlesex, is the guy that it's based off of. But anyways, we can employ both strategies, improved pillaging, improved maneuverability for 5 years, improved pillaging. So if we go with one strategy, we improve the opinion from one guy, but lose 10 opinion of the other guy. Or my commanders can act as they see fit. I think this one's good. That one that I chose, we get both strategies to work all for us. My Bishop Eldman has received a significant donation of gold from the state of wealthy but childless landlords, now deceased. He claims the departed lived a very frugal and pious life and wished for the gold to go where it could do good. Bishop Oldman insists that I receive part of the donation, as I am a paragon of Catholicism in Wessex. A tempting offer, indeed. I promise the gold will serve the realm. We get 50 gold. This paragon deserves the entire donation. Oh, that's awful. You are just and honest. 100 stress, no? Edmund gets 35. Please give it to the poor in my name. Oh, man. Even when you're a Christian, it's hard to make decisions that, will be, you know, good and bad, you know? Let's see. How does he feel about me right now? He's kind of neutral. He likes me a little bit. Do we need the gold? I can't think of what to use the gold. I think we could use the crosses later, so I'm gonna give it to the poor. This army's taken off, so we need to kind of watch this army and see where they go. Ah, there they are. I knew it. Need to march to them as fast as possible. Oh, we won the war against the Crusader, Jarl Ivar the Boneless. Alright, he pays 135 to King Edmund of East Anglia, and he spent 350 crown. Prestige, I'm sorry. Aeslith presents me with a perfect little son. One day, child, you'll carry on my legacy. What name would benefit a king? Alright, what should we name my son? I think we should name him Benjamin. Benjamin. May he go strong and wise, my son. Get on the boats, get on the boats, get on the boats. Get on the boats. Get on the boats. Hurry. Hurry. Move it. Move it. Move it. There we go. Yes, we all joined in at once. Good. Good. Wow, that was close. If I didn't move fast. You guys all saw that. I was way down here. If I didn't get over my butt over there, this would have been a lost cause. Look, we defeated the Vikings. Oh, thank goodness. Oh my gosh. Alright, so we're going to take out these Vikings piecemeal. First, we're going to go after this guy here. Oop, no, we better not. We better stay with our guys still. If we're going to have any hope of winning. Come on. Come on. Help me. Help me. Alright, good. Alright. We're gonna join with our teammates, because we gotta act as one team. That's the only way we're going to defeat these Vikings. So far, we got 60% victory. So, good. This is the siege. Alright, this is what the siege looks like. These are siege events. This says sickness is spreading. So that's good for us. When that siege event happens, it means we get more things happening. Stalemate, that means that there's no effect on the siege. Alright, we gotta think of what else we can do. Siege progress 5 plus 5, so we're gonna win this year. Alright. Alright. So we're going to follow our allies. Because that's our best option here. Use this. Looks like our allies are on the move. I've come to discover a most appalling truth about Earl Uhtred. Oh no, though I loathe to bring this matter to your attention, I must inform you this man is keeping secrets of the most alarming kind from you. So what should I do? Let's see, Alan, are you still there? What should I do? Your concern is deeply appreciated. Earl Uhtred's secret will be revealed to me. But I'll gain some stress, and I'll lose opinion from Earl Uhtred. Or, Earl Uhtred will get 30 opinion of me, and lose 10... Well, not... Oh, this guy right here, he'll lose 10 opinion of me. But Earl Uhtred gets 30 opinion of me. Let's see... Oh, I'm sorry. I'm like looking at my stream. I'm like, no one's replying. And then I check it. I click a button on the stream. So I checked my stream, Alan, and I can't go to 480 because I checked it, and it only plays at 720 for some reason. I can't figure out how to lower the settings. Yeah, I tried to fix the stream, but I'll look into the next stream to turn down the settings so you're able to watch it. This is a PC. Yeah, this is a PC game. This is Crusader Kings 3, but this is a... Most of the games that I play are PC games, but like Halo 5, State of Decay, what other games do I have? Rise, Son of Rome. State of Decay, Halo 5, Rise, Son of Rome. Those are all Xbox Ones, but I usually play PC. So these are all PC games. The first one. You talking about Benjamin for the first son? Yeah, that is. Oh, your concern is deeply appreciated. All right. That's what you're asking for. We're gonna make Uhtred mad, but we're gonna find out his secret. He has a deviant secret. Oh no, what does deviant mean? Where is it at? This is the guy here. But I don't see it anywhere. Huh. It just doesn't show it. Interesting. Okay. Oh gosh. What's going on? 3,000 here. 2,000 here. Vikings are over here. I'm gonna fight them. Hopefully. Uh-oh, not good. Vikings are joining forces. Can't make up my mind. Alright. We're gonna have to sit back. Play it safe. That other Viking just left. So our forces are evenly matched when we have them together. Hold on a second. I'm gonna see if we can't raise any more men. Alright, that's 500 men. Send them up. We need all the men we can get. Hopefully they get up just in time. Hold on, hurry up. Double quick march. Forced march. Whatever. Keep going. Oh gosh. The battle's gonna happen. Hold on. Follow them. Oh, we got a victory. Yes. We won. Alright, so now we just disband all these soldiers. And now we go to ruling...